Sheer greetings, our dear students. Welcome to the fifth lecture that is devoted to the science of Slavic applied science. And we are quite happy to see all of you. And of course, we're going to have a very special task today. The topic of our lecture would be the mind systems. As far as you remember, during the previous lecture, we used to study several structures and several mind systems. Today we are going to pay quite certain attention according to the first and the third systems. We are going to know how they work. We are going to work over such notions as types and models of behavior. And we are going to stick to a very special notion like memory. So the main task is to know how the memory as a system works. And right now I'm quite happy to give the word to our outstanding pro, to Chief Director of the Austrian Scientific Research Institute, the United Society of Russian Science in Europe, who is, by the way, also the general constructor of a new brand, Swift Pro 613. So, please, Олег Мальцев.
Эта лекция, она будет как бы продолжением предыдущей лекции.
This lecture is going to be just like a certain continuation of the previous one. It's like the second part of that lecture.
На прошлом занятии мы изучали с вами некоторые механизмы, которые нам необходимы для того, чтобы понять механизмы реализации задач, то есть достижения результата.
During the previous lectures, we would study certain systems and gears that are to help us to know how everything works. Why should we know that? Simply because we should know how to achieve the results. That's why we study certain systems.
И вы помните, на прошлом занятии у нас возникли трудности, связанные с тем, что английский язык, как бы, он не позволяет как бы объяснить глубину в силу того, что в английском языке одно и то же слово означает несколько значений.
And as far as you remember, during the previous lecture we faced certain problems concerning the difference in interpretation of different notions, like some of the notions in Russian language do not interfere and sometimes even contradict with the notions in the English language. Because of the diversity of meanings, just that one word has in the English language, we have faced certain problems. And right now we are going to pursue our studies just in order to overcome those problems and moments.
Именно поэтому мы как бы пошли механическим подходом без названий.
So, in order to deepen our understanding of those notions, we've decided to take a special approach. We've decided just to switch off the notions and just give the numbers to the system and the structures we are going to be aware of.
То есть мы договорились, условились между собой, что мы будем рассматривать некие механизмы вместо того, чтобы давать им какие-то названия, которые вызывали бы разное понимание.
That is the main reason why we agreed on certain conceptual points. Like, we've decided to switch off the notions just in order to dismiss the misinterpretation of this or that notion. That's why we just came up to the decision that the best idea in this situation would be just to give the numbers to the system. And it's quite easy to know either this system or that system is being worked out just with the number that it's given to.
Поэтому мы сказали, ну, как бы мы условились с вами, что мы будем иметь дело с механизмами 1, 2 и 3.
That's why we have agreed on the situation that we are going to deal with three special systems or gears, like the first system, the second system, and the third system.
Да, то есть как бы, и когда у нас появятся новые механизмы, да, мы им тоже присвоим, так сказать, цифровые, значение. Да, чтобы и будем исходить из номеров механизма, а не из названий.
So this is just the beginning, because right now we are working just with three systems. But in the future, as we pursue our studies, of course, we are going to face some more, some new systems. And we are going to give them numbers as well, like the fourth, the fifth, and so on.
И первое, о чем сегодня пойдет разговор, это о механизме номер один.
So, according to our studies, as for today, we are going to start with the very first system, or with the first mind gear.
Дело в том, что механизм номер один – это механизм, который как раз сам механизм достижения результата.
As the case stands, the first system, or the first mind gear, is just right that very system that allows every person or any human to achieve his goal and to receive the result he wants to.
И, как вы понимаете, сразу становится вопрос о том, о способах, о разных способах, вероятно, достижения результатов, разных способов достижения результатов, которые использует человек на планете Земля сегодня. Ну, то есть, как бы, потому что эти механизмы все, они, ну, не обязательно используются в воинском искусстве. Они используются вот каждый день, повседневно, как бы, когда вы там, не знаю, покупаете газету, не знаю, водите автомобиль, или идете там баскетбол смотреть, на концерт идете, в оперу и так далее.
And as a matter of fact, right now we are all becoming concerned of such a situation that, of course, in everyday life any human is facing certain situations, so he is facing variable systems and variable gears. But, of course, the main question that we are starting to follow right now is considering the fact that what kind of methods or what methodology should we use in order to know which kind of system we are really dealing with. Because actually, as for the systems themselves, they are ancient systems in line in the sphere of business security provision. No, because in your everyday life, just in your daily life, when you're doing something like buying just a newspaper, you are facing certain systems as well. So what should we do in such situation? We are going to study that as well.
Вот, и, в общем-то, как это можно было бы сразу понять для себя, да? Но прежде чем пойти в оперу, да, нужно купить билет. То есть нужно достигнуть некого результата для того, чтобы, ну, прийти в оперу. Так вот, как раз механизм номер один, он позволяет прийти в оперу, то есть купить билет и зайти в оперу. Так действует человек.
So, as for the first system, it's that very system that allows a person to receive the result. Let's just take quite easy example for understanding. As for the methods of task implementation. Look, just for instance, you have a desire or just have a certain intention to go to the opera, to watch some kind of libro or some kind of concert. But before you would be allowed to take that concert in the opera, you should buy some kind of ticket. So how to implement that task of the opera concert watching? How to come to the idea that first of all you should buy the ticket, and only on the basis of this concept that you're going to the opera concert, right? Only by understanding that process, like a whole structure or like a whole system, you would be able to go to that opera concert. And this is the first system that allows a human create ideas which altogether building a structure give him a result.
То есть существует некий механизм, который человек эксплуатирует. У него есть разные проявления у этого механизма, и получает при этом как бы результаты, разные результаты совершенно в жизни.
So, as a matter of fact, in his daily life, a person always faces diverse number of systems. But, as a matter of fact, As for that or those systems he uses, he receives different results. So the main idea is, in order to receive some kind of result, you should apply something towards any situation. So what should you apply, and how to operate around that very system? That's what we are going to know.
То есть, чем дальше вы будете учиться в академии, тем глубже мы будем исследовать эти механизмы.
So, the more you are going to pursue to continue your academic studies, the more we are going to deepen our knowledge according to those very systems.
Этот механизм, то есть номер один, номер два, номер три. И вам может показаться, что мы сейчас изучим как бы некий общий раздел, перейдем к практической части и забудем про эти механизмы. Это не так. В самой практической части, кроме этих механизмов, никаких другими механизмами, то есть один, два, три и другие, которые мы будем изучать, кроме механизмов, которые мы здесь изучаем, мы не будем ничем пользоваться. И человек вообще ничем не пользуется, кроме этих механизмов, потому что других механизмов у него как бы нет.
Okay, so the main idea you should get aware of is that, first of all, of course, we are going to study the theoretical part concerning those systems. But after those kinds of studies, we are going to follow and switch to the practical part. But please, do not think that at that very step or moment, you are going to just dismiss those knowledge that is devoted to the systems or some kind of gears, and you will have an opportunity just of forgetting them. No, it's not like that, because just according to the practical part, this is just that very area where these systems are quite necessary for successful operating and management. Certainly, because there is nothing in practice, nothing employable and manageable except for those systems. Actually, everything that we are going to deal with during the process of our studies, as well as during the process of your working, are how to operate those systems, which kind of methods should be used, and what exactly should you do. Without the knowledge of these various systems, it's quite impossible to do that. That's why we are paying such certain emphatic attention according to those notions.
То есть вам сейчас нужно понять, что это такое. Задача вот сейчас понять, что это такое. А глубина, ну то есть полное понимание, как раз и придет в процессе практики в академии, в течение вот всего периода обучения.
So, as for this very moment, your main task is to know and to understand what exactly it is meant by the systems. That's what we're studying right now. This is your first task. Of course, gradually, little by little, inch by inch, we are going during the practical exercises and practical lectures, we are going to study, to research, and to deepen our knowledge according to those systems. So, it's certain kind of process that takes time, but the first very step you are to do right now is to put your best effort in order to understand what is the system and how it works.
И поэтому каждый из вас должен четко понимать, что я в академии говорю крайне ненаучно, и это связано только с тем, что если я начну говорить научно, ну, научным языком, то я не смогу вам объяснить на английском, что это такое, и вы не получите никаких результатов. Ну да, и учеба в академии совершенно бесполезна.
Okay, and as for now, the next idea you should get off is that as for the language, as for the terms and notions we're dealing with right now, they are not too scientific. I know Mr. Maltsev is not just trying to pursue the scientific approach. He's not using too many scientific words, certainly due to the fact that if he does and if he uses, you won't be able just to understand what you're dealing with, and there would be just no success of that knowledge that you are to be given here on the academy. That's why we are using just kind of daily language in order to make you understand what you're actually dealing with.
Поэтому мы выбрали вот некий такой средний английский, непрофессиональный английский. Ну вот выбрали непрофессиональный, потому что в нашей академии учатся ученики, студенты, курсанты, назовите это как хотите, совершенно с разным уровнем подготовки. Кто-то является профессиональным военным, кто-то много лет работает там, охраняет правопорядок, кто-то занимается воинскими искусствами, кто-то еще чем-то занимается, кто-то вообще до этого ничем не занимался. И для того, чтобы вам всем одновременно было понятно, вот то, о чем мы говорим, мы выбрали вот такой средний английский, который более-менее понятен, ну, я не знаю, большинству из вас. И то возникают вопросы по 15 штук за один раз, да, которые приходится объяснять. Да, и то. Поэтому те, кто является суперпрофессионалом, считает себя вторым человеком после Бога, как бы на земле, в области английского языка, этим людям бы мне хотелось, ну, как бы достаточно четко сказать, что в принципе, вам придется потерпеть. Вам придется потерпеть вот этот вот непрофессиональный английский язык, не милитаризированный.
Okay. Okay, so this is the main reason explaining the decision that we have taken already. As for choosing just the medium level, non-professional level of the terms that are used by me right now as for the English language. Certainly this is due to the fact all our students, especially all our foreigners, they have variable, they have different levels of preparation. Some of them are, of course, professional militarists. Some of them have just started to learn this science. Some of them are already working for some period of time in the sphere of personal safety or business security provision. So you are all different. That's why we have decided just to choose that term plus of the language, I mean of the English language, which is quite non-professional on the one hand, but it's quite understandable on the other hand for the majority of you, who mean you, our foreign students. So, but even in that case, as the practice shows, there are some of us and there are some of you who still, even after watching, viewing and reviewing the lectures with this medium level English, they still have some questions, and even like 15 questions at just one time, according to one lecture. And of course, there are even people in our academy, there are students in our academy who tend to think that maybe they're just like second people after guard in the area of business security provision. But still, even such people have questions. So, just imagine what might have happened in case we have decided to take the scientific way of studies.
Где там вам рецепт?
So, right now we are going to see the recipe.
Когда вам что-то не нравится?
In case you don't like something.
Вы идете к зеркалу.
You're just moving towards the mirror.
Поправляете свое лицо. Ставите его
Check up whether your face is okay.
Ставите его на место.
Put it, if it is apart, you put it all together.
Да. Пересматриваете этот кусок вот этой лекции.
Then you rewatch this part of the lecture.
И продолжайте учиться.
And continue your studies, just pursuing.
В следующий раз точно так же, как я вот сейчас объясню.
And take it as your habit. In case you follow certain probabilities and difficulties, just do what you were already told of.
То есть необходимо иметь зеркало.
So everything you need is just a mirror.
Для того, чтобы поправить лицо.
In order to put your face that is torn apart.
И еще раз пересмотреть то, что я сказал, вот.
And rewatch the election once again.
Okay?
I guess it's clear.
Итак, то есть раз всем все понятно, мы можем перейти к работе.
So in case everything is okay and quite clear, let's switch directly to our working process.
Для того, чтобы объяснить механизм номер один, мне понадобится, чтобы вы выслушали от меня определенную историю.
So, first of all, in order to make you understand everything that concerns the first very system and the first very gear, you are to listen to one story, which is going to follow. Try your hard, do your best and listen.
Okay. То есть, представьте себе самолет.
Just imagine a plane.
У самолета есть стадии определенные, ну, которые он выполняет в ходе, когда его используют по его, ну, непосредственному назначению как самолет.
As for the usage of the plane, you know what plane is. There is big mechanical part that's flying from one continent to another continent. So, as for the usage and appliance of this very plane, there are certain different levels of its very usage. There are certain different methods of how this plane could be employed.
То есть, самолет, он взлетает. Взлетает.
So, for example, the plane takes off. Right?
Потом летит куда-то.
After taking off, it's flying somewhere.
Потом он вынужден совершать посадку.
After that, it's to ground,
и
to land.
Во время полета у него еще бывают, ну, некие нештатные, как бы, ситуации.
And apart from taking off, flying and landing, during the process of flying itself, the plane may face certain different situations that might occur, like non-standard situations.
Так вот, когда самолет взлетает и садится, здесь требуется ручное управление самолетом.
So, when the plane takes off and when the plane lands, the pilots use the special hand control. They control the plane on their own. With their mind, with their hands. It's like a hand control.
То есть, когда он летит из точки в точку, включается автопилот. То есть, есть точка, где он находится, есть точка, так сказать, где, куда надо прибыть, есть направление, так сказать, движения в системе, как бы, координат, и он летит автоматически на автопилоте. Из точки в точку.
Okay, let's take another situation apart from taking off and landing. Just imagine the plane is following a certain destination. This is the coordinate system where the plane works. And he's following a certain destination. He's getting his passengers from the destination point A to the destination point B. And whilst he is doing that, the autopilot system works. So the pilots just switch a certain system in order to take from the point A to the point B, right? It's like that.
То есть, бывают ситуации, когда, ну, как бы, он ничего не видит, ну, как бы, не знает, куда лететь, и тогда он вынужден лететь по приборам, да? То есть, есть пилотирование, как бы, самолета только по приборам. То есть, когда мы пилотируем самолет, исключительно ориентируясь на показания приборов.
Let's take another situation according to that flight once again. Sometimes a certain situation might occur when the pilots do not see anything. You know, it's like too foggy or just too misty or something like that. They do not see anything, but still they have the task to get from the destination point A to the destination point B. So what do they use then? They use the special apparatus system, and this system tells them what to do. So they just watch over all the gears they have in their pilot cabin. They watch the information the apparatus has given them, and they take the flight successfully.
А бывает такая ситуация, когда я, ну, и приборами не могу пользоваться, потому что приборы показывают разные, как бы, вещи, там, ну, ужасные. Да? Один прибор одно показывает, другой другое. Я там в грозу попал, еще куда-то там. Да? И тогда я вынужден обратиться к сторонней помощи, к помощи извне, к диспетчеру. И попросить диспетчера, так как ему все видно, чтобы он ну, как бы подирижировал моими передвижениями самолета, чтобы я безопасно мог добраться из пункта А в пункт как бы Б. Да? Вот так.
So that was the second situation. But one more situation might occur, such as, for example, the different gears, the different apparatus system are giving you different information. And this information is just contradictory, but still you have to get successfully from A to B destination points, right? So what are the pilots to do in such situation? They have to switch to another person, to the department crew who is on land, on the continent, just to make a special call, and they are going to be conducted from that department crew. It's somewhere on the earth, department crew, okay? And this department crew tells the pilots what should they do, which height to take, where to turn, and so on and so forth, in order to make this flight go successful. So this is the third situation that might occur.
Как вы видите, все четыре разновидности как бы, вот этих вот вещей имеют место быть в жизни, да? Все четыре разновидности вещей имеют место быть.
So, as far as you may judge right now, there are four varieties of situations that we watched already, right? Like, when you use, like, handy operating system, remember, right? When the pilots are to take off the flight, they do that on their own, with their hands and with their mind, with their skills, actually. This is the first situation. The second situation concerns the autopilot system, just switching the certain program. Whilst the third is turning to the apparatus system. They are watching the information they are given. And the fourth one, when they are listening to the department crew instructions and conductions. And these are the four situations, the four types that might happen during the task implementation process, okay?
Значит, и также и у человека, как у самолета, существует четыре способа реализации задачи. То есть их четыре. Других вариантов не существует.
So, according to this plain example, as we have come to the conclusion that there are four ways of task implementation, we may come to the principle that these four ways, as for the human way of task implementing, are still the same. So it doesn't matter whether it's a plane or a human. We are right now to explain you the main principle concerning four different ways any task in your life could get solved. That's what we're talking about.
То есть любую задачу на планете Земля при прочих равных условиях можно было бы решить словом, ну, при помощи слова.
So, let's move on. On the basis of these conclusions, taking quite equal conditions, we can watch four ways in which any person or any human is able to implement his daily task. The first way, according to which he is able of doing that, is to use the word. The word method, or the word way, is one of the four ways a person uses in his life in order to implement various tasks.
Существуют задачи, решаемые при помощи вот этой кибернетической, автоматической как бы системы. Автопилот.
Apart from the word system, we may use a special automatic cybernetic system. In case right now it seems for you quite complicated, just remind yourself of the example concerning the autopilot system usage, okay? So this is the second way with which and according to which a task could be implemented by any person.
Есть, где надо перейти на ручное управление. Эта вещь называется вертикально-горизонтальная система решения задачи.
Of course, certain situations might occur when you are to operate the situation together with your hands, with your skills. And from the scientific point of view, according to the Slavic applied science, this method is called the vertical horizontal way system of task implementation. It's like your mind and your handicraft done, built all together.
И есть вертикальная система решения задачи.
And let's switch to the fourth and the last way of task implementation. It's the vertical system. Vertical system, which we may use in order to implement our task.
И мы будем считать, что она подобна полету по приборам.
And in order to make it quite clear what the vertical system itself represents, let's switch to the apparatus system principle, okay? It's like that.
То есть есть решение задачи, ну, механизм решения задачи. Этот же механизм, да, решение задач посредством слова. Мы используем автоматическую функцию при решении задач. Мы используем вертикально-горизонтальную систему, когда мы переходим на ручное как бы управление, и вертикальную систему, когда мы вот, что-то находится вне нашего видения, как бы, да, или нам необходимо каким-то образом реализовывать задачу с большей силой.
So, on the basis of the given information, let's make a conclusion that, once again, there are four ways in which any person is able of task implementation work, right? You may use the words, and with a word, using the word, implement your task, or you can use just some kind of automatic cybernetic system, when everything's done automatically, right? You may use the vertical horizontal system. It's just like when you are to switch to the autopilot system, right? And you may use the vertical system. It's just the way when you turn to the information that all your apparatus and gears are giving you.
А в чем, в общем-то, проблема?
So let's switch to the main problem all that stuff might bring you.
Ну, во-первых, в ограничениях. Ну, например, слово, оно по дистанции ограничено. Если вы не применяете каких-то усилителей, протезов в виде телефона там, и так далее, и тому подобное. То есть, что я хочу сказать? Ну, для того, чтобы мне решать задачу посредством слова, мне человек вот, ну, как бы вот так передо мной нужен, то есть, как бы, чтобы я ему мог, ну, как бы говорить, или группа лиц, с которыми я могу говорить, понимаете? То есть, если они находятся где-то за 3-9 земель, извини за выражение, я никаким способом, ну, и не имея телефона, я никаким способом поговорить с ними как бы не смогу. Да? То есть и задачу, значит, решить что? Не смогу реализовать ее. То есть надо отличать решение от реализации. Решение это вот как бы как я собираюсь как бы, ну, это сделать. А уже внедрение, да, то есть, как бы, когда я пошел и сделал, да, то есть, как бы, и это все вот этот механизм номер один. То есть он достаточно могущественный. Этот механизм номер один очень могущественный. Потому он и механизм номер один, да. Он могущественный, да, механизм, да, у человека. Да.
Okay, once again. From now on, let's talk about the boundaries and obstacles and certain merits we may face using this or that way of task implementation, okay? Let's go to the first one, to the word. The main problem we may follow is that the word is quite submerged with a distance. Because there is always a certain distance between you and your opponent. And maybe your opponent is quite far from you. That's where a great situation when you have some kind of mobile phone or just a cell phone to make a phone call to him. But just in case he is far away and you do not have any special gears in order to help you and reinforce the power of your word, okay? So in this case, such system as the word system of task implementation, it doesn't work everywhere and in every single situation, simply due to the fact you need some distance. The best idea, of course, to put your opponent or to put another terminal in front of you, and the distance would be the shortest, and the power of the word in order to implement the task would be the best one, the highest, as for the level. But still, how to do that and how to make decisions, and by putting those decisions in the working structure to receive the realization, this is what the first system is telling us about. The first system is dealing with how to decide and how to create the decision of what kind, which type, or what way should be taken and chosen in order to implement the task. By the way, we want you to interfere with different notions like decision and realization. Decision is what way you use and what exactly you use in order to implement the task. Then you take this decision, put it, just stick it into the working system, and then by operating the system, you receive the realization or the result. So these two notions, they're quite different, and the difference in meaning between them, you are to understand. That's what we're talking about, and that's what the first system tells us about.
Вот. И, в общем-то, проблема с полетом по приборам, да, если его так можно назвать, да, в том, что человеку надо, во-первых, ну, как бы уметь различать эти, ну, как бы показания приборов, да, а с другой стороны, он должен уметь летать по приборам. Да, то есть, по сути своей, это и есть вертикальная система решения задач, это и есть тот бесконтакт, о котором, в общем, да, так много сейчас толков, кривотолков и, так сказать, скажем так, споров. А на самом деле, это такой же точно способ решения задачи, как и словом, да, только вот такой. И у них, безусловно, у каждого здесь есть как бы диапазон как бы применения, диапазон применения, и есть как бы сила, с которой оно как бы применяется. Да.
So let's switch to another merit or another boundary that is connected with the vertical system usage. As far as you remember, by the vertical system usage example, we have taken the apparatus system flight, right? But still, there are certain boundaries and obstacles that a person may face by the usage of this very system, simply due to the fact that, first of all, he should know what kind of apparatus he should deal with then. He should be skilled enough in order to interpret what kind of information he is given with those apparatus. And of course, he should be aware of what he should do, what knowledge to use, and how to create the correct conclusions in order to make that system work. So, the main striking point is quite vivid for you that you should know is that this vertical system principle, is the principle explaining us why and how the no-contact work is produced. So actually, from the point of combat system view, it could be explained like no-contact work is just one way of task implementation, right? And as for the no-contact itself, the principle it uses is the same as the vertical system way of task implementation principle is. So this is the no-contact work is not just so mysterious or vivid or just striking idea or notion or concept. No, it's not like that. Of course, even just when we face certain situation, there are lots of rumors, there are lots of rows, there are plenty of contradictory and even unpredictable scientific points of view according to the no-contact work, but still, the first idea that can explain you everything and make it quite clear for you that the principle of the no-contact work is the principle of vertical system way of task implementation usage. That's it.
То есть, и, в общем-то, каждая из этих механизмов решения задачи, вариантов решения задачи, они нужны в свое место и в свое время. Да, то есть они все четыре важны и нужны. Но проблематика на сегодняшний день человечества состоит в том, что кроме автоматической системы, неконтролируемой реализации задачи, человек ничего не использует.
So, one more important conclusion we should just note of is as follows. All these four ways and four methods of task implementations are equally important to you. And of course, you should be aware of what kind of method in which situation is better off to get applied with. But the main idea in contemporary life of any human concerns such matter of fact that any person uses just automatic cybernetic system. He wants everything to be done automatically. And that's the reason why he uses this very way of task implementation. And he's not aware of any other three systems. And this is the only one system he uses. And this is one just stream of problems that he faces every day.
В общем-то, в чем проблема?
Let's talk about the problem as the case stands.
То есть мы применяем автоматическую систему не по назначению. Она не предназначена для того, чтобы реализовывать задачу. У нее совершенно другое назначение, но мы об этом не знаем.
So, the problem comes out of the fact that automatic cybernetic system is used by a human in order to implement the task. That is, it's in the condition of non-employable situation, right? Automatic cybernetic system was created just for some other ideas and it has some other functions, but people are not aware of that state of things and they are using this automatic cybernetic system just everywhere in every single situation. But it's non-applicable for all those situations because there are three another terms and ways which are applicable, and this is that very contradictory basis which you should be aware of in order to know how to implement the tasks in your life.
То есть понятно, да? То есть именно отсюда все неприятности. То есть большинство людей пытаются все в своей жизни довести до автоматизма. А это путь к поражению.
So this is that very ground on which all misfortunes stand. This is that very ground out of which all our problems come. Simply because every person wants somehow, either consciously or subconsciously, to be done everything in his life and to just to make it appear, or just came out, like in an automatic way, without his own effort. Everything should be done automatically. And that's what every single idle contemporary person is aware of. And this is his own wish and this is his own desire. But it's not like that. And for certain situations, another way should be used. But still, even if you know that, it's a habit for him as to use some kind of automatic system.
В общем-то, каждый человек, он двигается в направлении постановки всего на автомат, на автоматизм. То есть он хочет использовать автоматизм, при этом ожидает получить результат. Но так ничего не получится. То есть за счет автоматизма результата получить нельзя.
So the main idea you should get conscious of is that every single person tries to receive everything in his life in an automatic way. He just switches to the automatic system of task implementation and somehow, I mean it's quite ridiculous, He's still waiting and expecting for any kind of results. But automatic system is not for results making, right? It's not for it. It is not applicable for those things. It has another function and another destination of appliance. But still, the majority of people are waiting and expecting these or those results by automatic systems usage.
А как он вот в воинском, например, искусстве реализует этот автоматизм?
So let's take an example of automatic system usage, just taken on the basis of combat system, okay?
То есть,
let's watch some kind of demonstration.
Я небольшой специалист в карате. Да, ну вот, например, удар в голову идет, да? Вот есть номенклатура школы, ну, то есть, как бы, приемы школы, то есть, ну, техника школы, которую вы, как бы, изучаете, да?
So, as for the practice of Mr. Maltsev, he is good enough in the school of karate, and he knows certain principles of this martial art system. And as far as you know, in each school, there is a special set of techniques and special set of skills that is provided towards their students and masters.
Ну вот, идет удар,
so,
как бы так,
the strike comes into, and he's trying to overcome the strike with his up movement with his hands, just in order to neutralize it, right?
Вот, то есть восходящим блоком нейтрализовывать его. Обратите внимание, то есть в чем проблема?
So he uses the block in order to neutralize its strike, but still he faces certain problem.
Просто человеку показали вот такой вот блок.
The problem is in the fact that a person himself was just shown off that very skill of a block movement.
Да, то есть, и он, отработав вот тысячу раз, начинает его в жизни применять.
And the problem is lying in the fact that this person or student just redone this block movement for 100 times. Actually, he just re-imitated what he saw.
Да, и переубедить его потом в том, что ну, существует что-то еще, очень-очень сложно.
And it's quite complicated in order to release him from any delusions after his hard, hearty work of 100 block movements studies.
Ну так, а по сути, что такое вот это восходящий вот этот блок?
But так. By the way, let's take the notion, what this block upwards movement is actually.
Ну, это вот, в общем-то, движение по щиту вверх.
Actually, let's take a shield, and this block movement is like the movement when another empty hand demonstrating, right? Just imagine like the hand is going from the top of the shield, from the bottom of the shield, sorry, till the top.
Теперь смотрите. Вот рука человеческая, она куда сгибается? Вот сюда, видите?
So please, let's look at the arm. You see, as a matter of fact, according to the nature of a human body, his arm could be joined just in this way.
То есть, по сути своей, вот таким вот способом блокировать руку как бы человека крайне неудобно.
So as a matter of fact, the blocking movement isn't quite natural. It's really uncomfortable and inconvenient to do that.
Почему?
You have to put some effort. So why is it so?
Разные дистанции как бы существуют с одной стороны. Во-вторых, обратите внимание, движение само по себе, оно очень энергоемкое.
So the problem is, on the one hand, that the distances may vary between you and your opponent, and as for the block movement itself, on the other hand, the movement itself is quite swift. And short.
Теперь обратите внимание, вот если я поставлю вот так руку, то обратите внимание, что происходит. Вот.
So let's take another example. Just imagine me of putting my right hand in such a way and watch what's going on.
То есть второй удар 100% достигнет как бы результата.
It's for 100%. I'm going to receive another strike.
То есть второй удар достигнет результата.
But if I'm going to strike in the second way, I'm going to receive the result I want to.
Теперь смотрите, вот, например, удар с правой руки, медленное ведение. Вот, смотрите. Вот у меня движение, смотрите, куда оно идет.
So let's watch the strike, the right hand strike, okay? Please, my the assistant has stopped in order to show you what the opponent is trying to do. You see, as a slow movement comes, it looks like that.
Он как бы меня сам разворачивает в удобное для меня положение.
Actually, you see, the opponent is switching you, in this case, Mr. Maltsev, up to the nature and quite convenient position right now he takes.
То есть я одно движение делаю.
Actually.
Не 10.
Actually, our instructor is doing just one movement, one simple movement, but not 10 of them. You see, one movement and that's it. The strike is gone off.
Понимаем, все мои движения направлены к массе.
You see, all the movements are brought towards the corpus, the body, to the mass.
Все движения направлены к массе.
All the movements are devoted to the mass structure.
Нелегко очень отсюда видеть, что происходит.
And from this very position, it's quite convenient to work. You see what's going on?
Вы можете сказать, что он может ударить этой рукой.
Okay, one more peculiarity may come out of you. You may say that another hand of the opponent is empty and Олег is going to receive another strike coming out of that hand.
Абсолютно верно, когда вытащит вот эту.
Yeah, he will be able of doing that. But before doing that, he should, actually he must take off his right hand first. And that's what happens then.
Еще раз. То есть я использую понимание вместо того, чтобы использовать технику.
So what is used right now? Mr. Maltsev uses understanding on the system work apart from usage of certain skills or imitational movements.
Потому что тот же удар прямой, да? Я его еще здесь остановить могу. Я его еще здесь остановить могу. То есть вот удар идет, смотрите.
Because as for the counter strike, as for the front strike itself, it could be stopped just like in the way it starts out.
Раз.
In such way, for example. This strike is to be stopped at any distance, like this.
Вот теперь два удара, попробуй сделать.
Okay, let's try to create two strikes simultaneously. You see what's going on?
Видите? У меня руки вверху, у него внизу. So, мои руки полностью блокируют движение его рук в руку.
Mr. Maltsev's hands are just upwards, and he is able of getting any block and or working against the opponent just in different ways.
То есть все почему так? Потому что я действую на основании понимания того, что я делаю, а не автоматически.
Why is it
so? Я не заучиваю технические элементы целыми днями, чтобы их довести до автоматизма, а потом этот автоматизм попытаться навязать другому человеку.
Why is it so? Why just could this situation happen? Simply because Mr. Maltsev uses the understanding of how the system itself works. He is not using certain movements or special blocks or special technique movements. He this or that school tells us to do, right? Because when you study the movement, when you memorize for 100 times one single movement, this movement becomes an automatic movement. And after that, you're just conscious enough that this very movement is only one movement that can just exist in this world. And after that, you're trying even to tell all your students or the people who surround you about that matter of fact. But it's not like that.
Okay. Вытираете это все и рисуете на доске механизм памяти человека. Всю память. Поняли, да?
Okay,
сможете нарисовать или нет? Да, ну вот, да, а я буду объяснять.
So I'm going to wipe off the board, and right now, as for our studies, we are going to switch to another notion and another system. Right now, we are going to talk about the memory system. We are going to watch the way the memory system works. Okay? So I'm going to make a sketch It's like a pattern for your own understanding of what the memory system is. You know, every person, every human has a memory, and it should be taken for granted that somehow this memory works. So, first of all, I'm going to put certain elements just as symbols, and we are going to get aware of what those symbols are standing for.
Это память человека.
So all together this system makes the memory system of the human.
То есть это механизм памяти человека.
It's the memory system. It's a setting. It's the structure of how the memory works.
Я уже говорил, кому ну, не нравится, тот идет к зеркалу, ну, поправляет лицо.
May I go?
Да. Поправляет лицо и там...
A small situation has occurred among our students, so let's go on once again. I'm going to explain. It's like a setting, a special mechanism that represents the whole memory system, okay?
Да. И вот у нас здесь есть четыре разновидности вот, реализации задачи. Вот это называется вертикальная система решения задачи. То есть нарисуйте вот так стрелочку, как одна система координат превращается в другую систему координат. То есть одно положение вещей заменяется на другое положение вещей.
Okay, so according to this system, let's look at what kind of methods of task implementation are to be used from now on. So, first of all, let's take this piece of puzzle, right? So, as for the vertical system of task implementation, I'm going to write it here, vertical system of task implementation, we mean that very situation when one state of things moving vertically just subholds the another state of things. Like, we create one coordinate system and apart from that state of system that we are in right now, we put in that created one. It's like one coordinate system submerges and moves out another coordinate system, and the state of things you want to is getting here on physics. And this is the vertical system principle.
Вот это бесконтакт. Это харийская яртыха.
And as for the usage, the vertical system, itself represents no contact work, in case we are talking about the combat system, right? It's no contact work, okay? And in Russia, as for the terms of Slavic applied science, this is the Hegelian Яртыха. It's a very specific word in Russian, and actually there are no contributives in the English language. It sounds like that. And this word, this term, represents the no contact word that is working according to the principle of working system, of vertical system task implementation. Okay? That's it.
Вот второй пазл, да, вот этот. Это когда дух воплощается в роли. Ну вот, две роли напротив друг друга стоят.
So, as for the symbols, here we have roles. These, like, I don't know, This is a symbol of a role. Remember, we were already a bit talking about the
role. Так мы роли рисовать будем.
Yes, we are going to use this symbol for the role, right? And in your life, you are using different roles. Here we have automatic role, right? Automatic role. And here we have a special role your spirit and your mind altogether create in order to come into, to make the realization. So this is a special role that is created by your spirit, whereas this is the automatic role that just all people are aware of and all people use.
Okay.
То есть вам нужно понять, что вот эта сила, да, вот дух, человек как дух, да, он воплощается на физике в трех вариантах. То есть вот он, ну, проявляется на физике в трех вариантах. В роли, в слове и в положении вещей, в системе координат.
So, from now on... One more important idea and conclusion you should be aware of, please put the notes, as for the spirit, you remember, according to the human structure, the spirit is the highest and the most powerful level, okay? As for the spirit implementation, it is capable of representing himself and appearing here in physics in three different ways. Like there are three of them, okay? The first way is when spirit represents itself in roles. It's like role playing, right? The second one, when the spirit represents itself in a word. Whilst the third one is concerning the coordinate system. Remember, we're already talking about the coordinate system, like old system, like a cupola beholding you. All the circumstances and surroundings there are round of you. This is the coordinate system. And as for the coordinate system, we are going to use this symbol. This is a symbol of coordinate system. Like a cupola. Inside of a cupola we may have a person.
То есть, обратите внимание, да, то есть как бы схематично это выглядит вот так. То есть некий дух, некая сила воплощается вот в болванке вашего тела. То есть роль выглядит как болванка вашего как бы тела.
So, this is just the schematic representation of how it works. It's just like a drawing using several symbols in order to make you understand how the system represents itself. So, what should you know afterwards? Let's move on. Moreover, the rules are used by the spirit in order to get implied here in this material and physical world. So, as for the role, let's talk a little bit of how it looks like. So the role itself looks like just like the body, like your own body. So in order for you, if you want to create a role, you just think of and put an imaginative figure representing your own body. And this is that role sphere, that role figure in which your spirit is going to implant afterwards. This is the way that your role looks like. Like your own body, it's an invisible figure you think of and imagine and put in front of you.
И вот как бы начинается, в общем-то, дальше. Сейчас мы дойдем до проблемы. В чем проблема? Почему не получается? То есть, почему не получается достигать тех результатов, которые вы как бы хотите? Следующая вот эта вот колонка, да, это вертикально-горизонтальная система решения задачи.
Okay, and on the basis of these all facts, we are going to come to the conclusions and work out all the reasons why sometimes in this or that situation we do not receive the results. And we are going to switch to this idea a little bit later. So, as for now, let's go to those pieces of puzzle. And as for the way of task implementation, here we use the vertical.
Стрелочку начерти.
I'm going to show everything with like this, right? Vertical horizontal system of task implementation. It's like this. In a sketch using the symbols, it's represented like this.
Окей, да? И последняя колонка – это решение задачи при помощи слова.
And as for the last column in all this structure, when we're using symbols, we're using them to show such way of task implementation. That is called the word system, right?
Так вот, как выглядит деятельность человека, который живет на Земле сегодня?
So let's look at the system showing us how the whole activity of any person who is living right now in the 21st century, I mean, today. So how it looks like?
Она характеризуется, ну, как бы представлением в пространстве и времени модели поведения. То есть он как бы выставляет модель поведения. Он выставляет модель поведения. В бою, везде.
So,
манера, вот они говорят, знаете, как манера боя, то есть как бы там еще чего-то. Yeah. То есть это как бы вот совокупность определенных признаков, да, которые говорят, что вот это характеризует его индивидуальность.
Okay, I'm just smiling because it's quite difficult to interpret that correctly, but I will do my best to do that. Okay, so. As a matter of fact, the contemporary life of any person could be swiftly represented in the form of a special manner of behavior. It's like a special model of behavior that represents specific features of any single individual. You know, every person is proud of having his own individuality. And according to this very individuality, he's showing up to the whole world and to the all people around him. He behaves in a very specific manner. Like, you know, in combat system schools, there are certain manners of fighting, there are certain manners of techniques, and so on and so forth. And as for the manner every human being and individual behaves like, when we are talking about this kind of system, we mean the model of behavior. So let's look like the model of behavior of the contemporary person looks like.
То есть, что делает современный человек? Он пользуется автоматическими клише, вот этими моделями поведения, ему привычными. То есть он их формирует долгое время, мы это будем изучать подробно. Он их формирует, эти стереотипы, долгое время, которые перерастают, то есть соединение стереотипов, множество стереотипов, вырастают в разновидности модели поведения, которую он и выставляет всем. Вот так. Да?
So. How does the system looks like as for the model of behavior? As far as you're already concerned, lots of people are told how to behave, what to say, what to use, what to imply or apply in their lives. Altogether, actually, all the things called just in general, are told like of the automatic cliches. So we are all aware of certain standards that the whole society is stuck to. We are all told of certain patterns of behavior, what to do and how to deal with certain people in different situations. And combined all together, all these patterns, all these clichés, all these automatic opinions, delusions, persuasions, and so on and so forth, that one person uses according to the whole people who surround him, represented by the model of behavior, is that very automatic system that he is always using in any situation. It's the feature, the specific feature of his own individuality, which we may see and face as his own model of behavior.
То есть, давайте мы посмотрим, как человек, по сути своей, действует.
So, according to this information, let's just watch, let's just reverse several examples, showing us how every single person acts throughout his life.
Okay. То есть он ищет вот там вот, вот в той вот первой ячейке неудачу, которая у него была в жизни. Вот здесь.
So, as for his behavior,
он роется в этом хранилище и ищет неудачу. Чего делать нельзя? Ну, что опасно?
What is every single person doing? First, as for the memory system and setting, let's switch to this one. First of all, he switches his attention to all his previous experience storage. Remember, we were already talking about the reactive incident storage, right? This is that very place where all his previous situation are based in and lying in. And he is once and once again looking and searching over his misfortunes that could be somehow connected with the situation he's facing right now. So this is the first place where his whole attention switches to.
Okay. То есть он ищет неудачу. Он ищет неудачу. Отсюда очень важный принцип, который мы будем дальше многократно, к которому будем возвращаться, изучать.
So, what is he actually doing? Actually, he's just searching for a kind of misfortune in order to use it as a basis. And this is an utmostly important and extraordinary serious thing for you to understand right now. Because the misfortune itself that is hidden in his experience is that very basis and pivot from which he is going to start with.
Человек никогда не идет в атаку до тех пор, пока не считает, что у него обеспечена оборона.
So, this information is to make us understand and come up to the conclusion that a person, any person actually, is never going to create and perform any attack against some other people until that very moment he is totally aware he is defended. Only after being conscious that he is defended enough, he is ready to create any attack.
Да, то есть вы можете, это увидеть на множестве демонстраций. То есть человек, для человека всегда важнее оборона, чем нападение. Всегда. То есть запомните это раз и навсегда. То есть отсюда очень-очень важный для работы вывод. Что в бою в рукопашном, что в огневом контакте, где бы это ни было, что просто в повседневной жизни. То есть прежде существует этап поиска как бы безопасности, собственно. То есть безопасность обеспечивает либо сила какая-то дополнительная, либо преимущество, либо протез, либо это что-то еще. То есть мне сначала нужно обезопасить себя, а потом я только буду атаковать.
So, as for any examples, considering your personal safety, you must get conscious of the fact that first of all, every person, both your rivals, your defenders, and so on and so forth, all people, first of all, think about their own self-defense. Only feeling self-defended, they are ready to act somehow else, like to make some kind of strikes or to create some kind of attacking. But at the same time, this principle is to be used throughout your whole life. It's both in the business security, in the personal safety area, right? Maybe it's just like the fisticuffs, maybe it's just like hand fighting, maybe it's knife fighting, maybe it's even using fire guns. All situations like that are based on the first very step of the previous misfortune searches, right? And the same principle is working throughout your daily life. Because in any human's daily life, all people first of all think of whether they had this situation before in their previous experience or not. And only after having found and feeling defended by this incident, they are ready to act somehow, like to attack, to pursue their movements, to follow, and so on and so forth. The principles work like that.
То есть, и поэтому как бы человек, он всегда, прежде чем что-то сделать, он этого не осознает. То, что я сейчас объясняю, он этого не осознает. То есть он этого не понимает, он это делает автоматически. Он ищет опорный инцидент, неудачу. Что делать не нужно. И это вот как бы срабатывает предохранитель. Что пока мы не найдем, так сказать, оборону, мы не найдем оборону. То есть давайте я покажу лучше, это будет лучше видно.
Before the demonstration comes, we are going to see how this principle actually works. That first of all, every person is, of course, searching for this or that initial incident in his experience that allows him to feel defended and to feel secure. So let's just take a demonstration of how it works just in a fight, in a fighting.
Он идет на меня, да?
So the opponent is approaching.
Смотрите, раз, то есть только руку заношу, делая образно, что я буду бить, и он останавливается.
So you see what happened? Mr. Мальцев just created one movement that gave his opponent an image, just an image of receiving a strike.
То есть это технические действия, никаких не применяю.
No techniques, no special movements, just giving the opponent the image, you see? He is ready to attack, he is ready to create great strike across his opponent. And this is how it works.
Встань, как стоял до этого. Вот. То есть он как бы замирает, не подходя к вам, для чего? Для того, чтобы как-то откорректировать свое действие в дальнейшем. Я же тоже начал действовать, да? Ему нужно сначала оборону обеспечить, да? А после этого только в атаку переходить.
So by seeing this image of attack, of course the opponent stops. He is just not ready to act somehow until he feels defended once again.
То есть вот боксеры, кто боксом занимается, у них есть такая, я так не умею, у меня почему-то привык я к правосторонней стойке. Но, я попробую в левосторонней. И вот как бы подходят, так щупая дистанцию.
So, as for the example that is connected with boxing and with boxers, professional boxers, usually it doesn't matter whether they're creating the attacks from the right-hand side or from the left-hand side. You see, the first thing they're trying to do is to feel the distance with their hand. First of all, they're trying to touch the distance with their hand, and only after that touching, they're ready to act and create a great strike.
То есть вот как бы причина в чем? Он ищет безопасную как бы дистанцию, с которой бы он опасно мог действовать, так сказать, в отношении лица, с которым боксирует.
So what is the reason of such behavior? The reason is in the fact that first of all the boxer is trying to find the safe distance between him and his opponent, and only after finding this very distance he is ready to act.
Да, то есть как бы поэтому вы должны запомнить, что любой человек, который занимается воинскими искусствами, да вообще в процессе жизни, он не нападает на другого как бы человека до тех пор, пока не чувствует в себе силы как бы напасть. То есть как бы вот не обеспечил я как бы силу большую, то есть преимущество, силу большую, чем у человека, или не обеспечил оборону. как бы собственно, да?
So, one more thing you should memorize and you should get aware of is that any person, any opponent never acts before finding secure position and before feeling safe. Only after that process is completed, only after the distance or position or posture is found, he is ready to act. So that's what comes first, like your personal safety. And the act itself comes as a second, right? And this is how it works, according to this model of behavior system taken out of the memory structure, right?
Понятно, да?
I hope so.
Да. То есть, по сути своей, человек действует вот так вот. Если схематично нарисовать.
So in a schematic way, any human just behaves in such a way. This is a structure, the system, showing us how any human acts.
То есть, и вот эта штука, вот эта линия, называется моделью поведения. Вот эта модель поведения. То есть, он ищет неудачу, после этого у него возникает вторая стадия, это соединение неудачи, принадлежащей определенной автоматической роли. Мы, когда систему автоматизма будем изучать, мы этот вопрос с вами будем подробно углублять.
So, as for the range itself, as for this line, these four pieces of puzzle all together combine this very model of behavior. So, this is the way how each person acts and how he behaves and how it works actually. So everything starts with his previous experience, where he is looking for his previous ideas and, of course, misfortunes that are connected with that situation. This is the first, right? Let's go to the second part. The second part is telling us that after that, a human creates a special rule that is connected with this situation. So, the role that doesn't contradict this very situation, the person stays in. And this is the second part, that's what happens, okay? So, once again, your previous experience, first it is found, then certain role creation, it's automatic role creation, and this is the second part.
И вот здесь вот как бы возникает вот эта так называемая стабилизирующая функция системы автоматизмов человеческого тела. Она выглядит вот так. Вот эта стабилизирующая функция. Сейчас я объясню, в чем она заключается.
So, let's move on. It's not the end. Then the third part appears. It's this part in science is called the stabilizing function of automatic cybernetic system.
Okay.
And right now we are going to research and to get aware of how it works. I mean this stabilizing function.
То есть вот эта роль.
This role.
А это двигательная лингвистическая цепочка.
And those symbols mean the dynamic motional chain.
То есть и смысл в стабилизирующей функции системы автоматизма человеческого тела заключается в том, чтобы многократно повторять вещь, которая в прошлом получилась.
Mm-hmm. So these symbols represent the...
То есть она постоянно повторяет одни и те же как бы действия, которые якобы получились.
The dynamic motional chain of those actions, which already somehow, according to your previous experience, gave you the result. According to these motional actions, according to your previous experience, in situation not like that, but somehow connected, once upon a time, you have already faced the result. And you're trying to reproduce the same result in a different situation by using the same dynamical motion chain actions. And this is how it works.
И вот отсюда возникает вот там, как бы две руки, вот ну, как бы два мяча, представьте себе, да? И это на дистанциях очень хорошо видно будет потом. То есть с одной стороны, с правой, да, я делаю то, что умею только.
So, to make it clearer, let's take an image of a warrior. An image of a warrior, okay? Who is holding two swords in his hands? He just standing with two swords, okay? And just in order to understand how all these dynamic motional chains work, just pretend that with one sword, he is doing something that he's already aware of. What he knows.
И левая, я жду шанс на дистанции, где я, ну как бы, может быть, и не умею ничего делать. Я его жду.
So that's what he's doing with his right hand. But still he has another hand with the left one. What's he doing with the left hand? With the left hand, he's waiting for any single chance in order to make a good catch, just to receive some kind of great result somehow, maybe, who knows. Chances may appear in our lives. So this is how it works. Let's switch to several demonstrations just in order to make it clearer how it works.
Значит, первый пример.
The first example is...
Первый пример. Это, вот, например, стоит человек, да, там как-то встал, как-то сбоку, не знаю, ну вот, да. Хорошее положение под бросок, да, а бросать я не умею. Но вот я жду некий шанс, который я могу увидеть, понимаете? Это с одной стороны. А с другой стороны, я боксер и могу бить только руками. При этом, совершенно странно, как констатируют все мои коллеги, я себя всегда лишаю своего главного арсенала. То есть я висну на противника после двух ударов.
So, as a matter of fact, there are certain situations might occur. As for example, two opponents are standing in a very good position for creating a throw. You know, to throw the opponent away. But one of the opponents is not aware of that hitch. He doesn't know how to create a throw. But somehow he's still waiting for any chance of a decent chance for him in order to give a certain punch across his opponent. Or pretend, the second example, pretend you're just a boxer and everything that you're aware of is boxing. That's why everywhere, in every single situation, you're looking for a chance to create a good boxing strike, right? But not all people use boxing, and some people know more than just boxing, and that's what just from this is the source from which all problems come.
Да, вы можете как бы очень, ну, много раз посмотреть, что после нескольких ударов они идут в клинч, ну то есть как бы обхватывают, лишая себя всячески себя и противника, ну как бы всяческой возможности дальше развивать технические какие-то действия. Да.
And you may see this very situation even in life, not only during the boxing championship, but still, when people do not know what to do next, and they are, for example, boxers, right? The situation is getting stopped by sticking into a clinch, because in a clinch, none of the opponent is ready of acting, of bringing some kind of dynamic motional chain actions, indeed. In a clinch, they're just holding each other tough enough in order to wait for some kind of chance and to have some time to think of what to do next. And this situation may occur even in your life, and it really occurs. This is how the principle works.
Да, и вот как бы смысл заключается в чем? Человек, он, значит, всегда, он всегда пытается реализовать что-то, ну, с наименьшим усилием, да, как ему кажется. При этом вынужден прикладывать огроменное вот это усилие, да, потому что он ограничивает себя сознательно вот этой вот стабилизирующей функцией системы автоматизма, как бы человеческого тела. Да.
So, the main problem is in the fact, why we wanted just to show you all this demonstration, just in short. By these two examples, we wanted to show you that people are always looking for some kind of dynamic motional chain actions that were already set in their previous misfortune storage. And they are doing that because they have nothing else in their skill storage, let's say like this. And this is the way they're trying to realize themselves, and they're trying to achieve the results they need to. And this is the way how that this function works. That's it?
То есть, обратите внимание на то, что сами модели поведения, бывают четырех как бы разновидностей. То есть, вот то, что я сейчас рассказываю, это два вида моделей поведения. То есть, то, о чем я сейчас рассказываю, вот это два вида моделей поведения. То есть, это модель поведения неэффективная, ну, то есть, как бы с поражением, да, которая ведет к поражению. И выгодная, которая тоже ведет к поражению, в конце концов.
So, that was the information about the stabilizing function of the model behavior and the automatic system. But altogether, talking about the models of behavior themselves, we should say that there are four types of those models. And by those demonstrations, you have already observed two of them. One type of model of behavior is called the non-effective type, non-effective. It brings no effect, actually. But still, if there is no effect and no result as a consequence, the model of behavior is being used by a person. That was the first one. Whilst the second one was quite profitable, right? So such model of behavior that helps you to receive profit, to win actually, and to get some profit. So this is the profitable type of model of behavior.
Еще существуют справедливые модели поведения и эффективные модели поведения.
Apart from those two models of behavior, there are two more. They are the effective behavior models. In order to receive the effect, the result, and the justifying, I would claim that way, justifying model of behavior that are based on justice.
Мы в академии будем с вами изучать вот это, то есть вот эти эффективные и справедливые модели как бы поведения, и будем отучать себя пользоваться вот этими моделями поведения.
So according to these types of model behavior, what are we going to do here during the process of studies that are given in the academic course? We are going to study the effective and justified models of behavior. We are going to get strongly and absolutely aware of how to create and how to use and apply these very types, effective and justifying, okay? Whilst, on the other hand, we are going to reteach ourselves and totally forget how to use non-effective and profitable model of behavior in our lives. This is what you should just forget about and switch to the effective justifying models. This is our program.
И, а вот этот вот кусочек, вот этот вот, вот треугольничек, он как бы означает ориентиры, на которые идет вот эта вот двигательно-лингвистическая цепочка. Ну, к какому ориентиру, какой ориентир достигает двигательно-лингвистическая цепочка?
So, but still, having watched this piece of puzzle, looks like we have missed one more piece, right? We haven't actually. Now it's time to switch our attention for it. By this symbol, we're going to name a special written point. So it's just like the point to which we are moving. This is that point that we are all oriented for to come. And this is the fact that that is connected with a dynamic motional chain. That's why a person uses this very dynamic motional chain automatically and not consciously, because he wants to achieve and get to this orienting point. This is the end of his movement, where he wants to come to.
Сейчас мы это все нарисуем комплексно на доске.
Подождите 2 секунды. Единственное, что я хотел бы вам дать понимание, вот сейчас, о том, что вот здесь результата нет. Результаты вот здесь, здесь, здесь и здесь. То есть вот оно проявление механизма номер 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. И его характерный признак проявляемости вот этого механизма номер 1, это управляемость. Все, что неуправляемо, не является механизмом номер 1. Все является вот этим механизмом. Модели как бы поведения. И при том вот эти двух разновидностей, да?
Okay, so after this very part, we are going to take all these systems separately and to watch them separately. We are going to wipe everything off the board and have a special attention according to this very part. But before I'm going to do that, my aim is to make it clear for you that this system that is used subconsciously and automatically by any person brings no result. It's non-resultative system, okay? The systems that really brings a person result works in such a way, and we were already talking about it. And still, even though we face 4 different ways of task implementation, and when we see 4 different ways a person realizes himself, still, these 4 ways are working stuck to the first system, the first mind system. And these are the varieties in which this system can be used by the person in order to achieve the result. Everything that is being achieved, I mean any result that is being achieved by the usage of this, of that system, that represents itself and works on the basis of the first mind system of a human, is called an operating approach, right? Manageable approach. That's all the all scope of results that are under your own control, and you can control it. Everything apart from those 4 ways, like this one, subconscious, no automatic, it brings no results, and it has nothing in common with that very first mind system, and you have to be aware of that. If you want to receive the result, you should know how to operate the system and which kind of method to use. One of those 4. And then your results will be controlled.
Так проявляется механизм номер 1. Вот. 1, 2, 3, 4.
This is how the first setting, the first mind system works. This is how we see it and how we observe it here in our material world. How you can just feel the way it exists by its working.
Okay. Откуда же появляются неэффективные и выгодные, твердые вот эти модели поведения?
So, according to our course of the Academy, we are going to stick to those 2, effective and justifying models of behavior, because according to these models of behavior, a person receives the results. And we are going to discharge those models of behavior. But still, we have to know out of which source and from where all these non-effectives and profitable models of behavior come from. Where do people take that from?
Где, откуда они появляются?
Yeah.
Да. Первые неэффективные. Mm-hmm. Из отказа выполнять задачу. То есть вы уже раз потерпели как бы неудачу, и вы просто в последующем вот это предохранитель используя, говорите: я уже ломал себе руки, спасибо, я больше не хочу. Да, то есть.
So, let's switch our attention to this term as non-effective model of behavior. Where does non-effectives come from? They come from such decision of the person when he has already decided to postpone the task implementation. He denied himself, he took it off, and he told himself he doesn't want to implement that task, he's not ready and he's not going to. Why is it so? Simply due to the fact, previously somehow, according to his experience, he has already faced some piece of misfortune. And he is aware of that piece, he remembers that misfortune, he remembers, for example, when he broke his arms, or he felt uncomfortable, or he felt even miserable, any kind of misfortune, you know what I'm talking about. And being stuck to this misfortune and to this ugly feeling, I would claim, he is choosing this non-effective model of behavior simply because he denied to implement any task.
То есть, карате это неплохо. Карате это неплохо. Это неэффективно.
So, let's take an example like of a karate, right? Let's take as an example this school of martial arts. It's neither good nor bad notion. It's neither good nor bad phenomena in our life, no. But it's non-effective. That's what you should know about it.
То есть, если вы попадете на лед, вы пытаетесь этой механикой карате ударить ногой, то вы упадете.
Why do we claim this? Let's take an example. For example, you're trying to make a counter reverse when you're staying on the ice, just imagine, the icy surface, and you're trying to perform some kind of karate movements, but on the ice with your leg, not with your arms, but with your leg. Just imagine, you're standing on the ice which is so slippery that your karate movements would bring you no result, and moreover, you will fall down being hurt.
Это касается не только карате, кунг-фу, еще каких-то школ боевых искусств. Это вообще касается всех систем, которые существуют как бы в мире.
And actually that state of things and that case concerns not only karate, no, just there are lots of them, like кунг-фу and some other branches of martial arts, which we are facing right now in the 21st century. Still, they're all neither good nor bad, just non-effective.
То есть, все эти системы, которые существуют в мире, это частный случай векового искажения изначального как бы знания, вот прошедшее через призму веков.
So, as for those systems, what do they represent themselves? Actually, all these systems, like karate, or kung-fu, or some other, by themselves, they're just small pieces of the whole broken picture. And by itself, this picture represents the initial knowledge picture that was and is actually existing throughout the long range of centuries. But according to these long range of centuries, we are not aware of this initial knowledge, and the only things that appear behind our eyes and in front of them are just certain separate pieces, like karate, like kung fu. They are the parts, the smallest pieces that combined all together create the whole initial system.
Наша задача вернуться к изначальному знанию.
So our main task on the basis of those conclusions would be to switch from the small pieces usage to the whole complex initial knowledge usage.
Освободившись от векового искажения.
Because, and how could that be done? By switching away all the delusions and all the prospectors' persuasions people have collected throughout the long period of time, throughout the long centuries.
Вторые модели поведения, вот эти вот, второй вид, да, вот эти выгодные твердые модели поведения, откуда они появляются?
So let's talk about the profitable models of behavior and about the source out of which they come from.
Вот. Какова их природа?
Let's search what is the nature of those models of behavior such as profitable.
Это с вами делятся своим опытом другие люди.
The nature is quite clear. These models of behavior come from the situation When other people who surround you try to give you the pieces of their own experience. They're just sharing their own experience with you. And out of this sharing, all these profitable models of behavior come from.
А вы принимаете их опыт за истину в первой инстанции.
But the main idea and the main problem about that stuff is that under their words and under their pieces of experience, you misinterpret the whole truth, the absolute truth actually, and the initial state of things, just because somebody has told you gorgeously about his good piece of experience.
Это происходит потому, что вы не обладаете знанием.
So, why this happens? This all happens due to the fact you do not owe this initial knowledge.
Да, вы не обладаете знанием. Наша задача в Академии сделать так, чтобы вы стали обладателем знания и не пользовались ничьим чужим опытом.
So, our main task here in the academy, as I mean the task of the instructors and consultants, right, would be to give you that initial knowledge and initial state of things, to help you to switch to that initial knowledge in order to misinterpret those models of behavior that come out of someone's previous experience. That is, to make you deny to use some other's previous experience. It would stand for nothing when you will be able to use the whole complex initial knowledge. And that's our aim.
То есть первое, что мы будем изучать в Академии, то, что мы будем делать в Академии, это приобретать вот это изначальное знание, то есть эталонное знание. А второе, это мы будем учиться эксплуатировать свою память, механизмы своей памяти в полном объеме. То есть не ограничивая свою память, там, ну вот так, например, вот так, не ограничивая ее вот так. То есть полный объем памяти, всю машину памяти человеческой, все механизмы взаимодействия с данными, все, вот мы полностью будем учиться эксплуатировать в полном диапазоне память, свою собственную память. Mm-hmm. Да, то есть вот этот механизм памяти мы будем изучать и учиться им пользоваться в полном объеме.
So, as for now, we are going to switch to what we are going to research and to become aware of. First of all, we are going to study and we are going to learn completely how to turn to the initial knowledge. How to switch ourselves to the initial system that is based on the echelons. How to use and to apply those echelons in our life. This is the first very idea which I would like emphatically to say. Whilst the second one is that we are going to study how the whole system of, I mean the memory setting works. And we are going to become quite well prepared and utmostly trained and ready to use and apply all those sectors as the parts of the whole memory complex system. That is why we're not going to create any boundaries here during the process of studies, no. We're not going to learn just how this one part of the memory works, or just how another one part of the memory works, no. We're going to study the whole complex in order to know how to use each component and how to operate the whole structure in order to receive results. And this is one of our main tasks here in the academy. The task is as follows. To know how to use your memory as the complex system throughout your life for successful task implementation.
Стирайте это все с доски.
Okay. So, as for now, I guess it's clear. I'm going to wipe off what we have already researched. So let's make a short break.
И вот мы как бы с вами нарисуем первый как бы рисунок вот здесь. Помните, вот эта система координат. Вот эта система координат. Это вот. Здесь как бы вот эта вот автоматическая роль. Здесь вот эта вот двигательно-лингвистическая цепочка, да? Двигательно-лингвистическая. И вот здесь ориентир, на который как бы идет как бы человек. Вот мы его видим с вами.
So look at the board. Right now we are going to research another sketch, another drawing. A special pattern we have already started. So here we have, as a scope, the coordinate system. Remember we're talking about the symbol that represents the coordinate system. Here we have an automatic rule that is used subconsciously according to the automatic cybernetic human body system, right? Here we have the dynamic motional chain of actions, remember, right? And here, by this symbol, we mean the point of orientation to which the human pursues and comes to.
То есть здесь мы просто эталоны меняем на ориентиры.
So what are we going to do according to this system?
То есть вместо First, эталонов у нас появляются ориентиры.
First, we are going to switch from the points of orientation to the echelons. That is, we just submerge, behold, like we take echelons and start applying them apart from the points of orientation.
И вот как бы вам нужно четко как бы понимать, то есть если машина памяти выглядит вот так, то есть машина памяти человека выглядит вот так.
So,
не надо рисовать, просто вот машина памяти.
What should be understood by you? So, if the memory system looks like this, we have already talked for quite a long period of time of how it works. You remember, like 8 pieces in this sketch, okay?
Ну, как прошлый рисунок, да? То и результаты, как бы они проживают вот здесь, да, результаты, они проживают вот здесь, то есть, вот помните, мы говорили, первый там.
And according to that memory system, let's take the idea where the results are got from, where do they come from, right? They come out of these four ways and methods of task implementation that work on the basis of the memory system. You see those four vertical systems, right?
Right. Вот. То очень важно, что вот вы в эти вот как бы вот видите, это как бы такая вот штука, как это объяснить? Стаканы, фильтры, сквозь которые проходит вот сюда вот, ну как бы вот стаканы, сквозь которые проходит вот сюда та субстанция, да, которая вот ну, воплощается в системе координат, влияет на положение вещей, да? И вот очень важно, что вы сюда наливаете. Что вы сюда наливаете. Понятно, да?
So, what are we going to explain you? Just imagine that this is the life where you live. And this is the system you operate or do not operate, okay? To make it clearer, let's take an image of four glasses with four filters. Here, you want to receive the pure water, okay? Or some kind of pure material or pure mixture, like pure juice or something like that, right? So, it's a very good question. What exactly you're pouring into those glasses with filters in order to receive the final mixture? Let's take an example of how the memory system works. Once again, just imagine that here we have four tubes with filters or four glasses, and you're pouring in all of those tubes something. And this is the question, what exactly what you're pouring in those glasses? If you're pouring muddy water, you're going to receive muddy water as a matter of fact. But if you're pouring something crystal here, you will receive the decent result. And this is the principle, this is the sketch and the image of how it works.
Даже если вы виртуозно умеете владеть, ну, владеете механизмами памяти, но наливаете сюда коктейль, спрайт, фанту, пепси-колу, другие напитки вместо изначального знания, эталонного знания, то в результате вы получите что? Опять неудачу. Опять неудачу. То есть вы получите не то, что вы как бы хотите, не то, что положено получить.
So, and the situation is as follows. When you want to receive a result, for example, in a result representing like the pure water, right? So in order to receive the pure water as a result, even having this system of four filtered glasses, even knowing how they work, still we face the question, what exactly should be poured into those glasses? So, if you want to receive the water, the pure water as a result, but you're pouring Fanta, Sprite, alcohol drinks, cocktails here, even with the usage of filters, still you will have just a mad mixture, but not the pure water right here, okay? With the results and task implementation, the situation is still the same. If you have the memory system and you're already aware of how it works, the question is, what are you pouring and what are you applying into that memory system? If you're applying something except for the initial knowledge, you are going to receive misfortune as a result, or such result which you didn't want and you didn't intend to receive. But when you pour in the initial knowledge, and when you operate in the total memory system, you're receiving the result you intended to. And this is how it works.
Понятно, да?
I hope it's clear.
Вот эти вещи вам нужно как бы запомнить. Вот эти вещи. Тогда возникает вопрос, а что же тогда такое механизм номер три, который называется сознание?
Okay, so... If you want to receive the results you want to, this is what you should just memorize and learn by heart, just some, put it somewhere deep into your soul. I don't know how to explain that in other words, but still, even having knowing what and how, what this setting represents and how it works, still we may face next question. The question is, we are aware of the second mind system, and we're already aware of the first mind system. But what about the third one? What does the third mind system represent by itself?
Теперь очень внимательно.
We're talking about the consciousness as the third mind system, and please be very attentive.
Механизм взаимодействия, обеспечивающий взаимодействие между памятью человека и системой координат называется сознание. Еще раз. Механизм, обеспечивающий взаимодействие между памятью человека и системой координат, называется сознанием. Ничего не учат ни в одном учебном заведении.
Еще раз. This is that very thing that is not, that is not given as an explanation at any university, just in any corner of the world. So, what the consciousness stands for? What is a consciousness by the notion itself? It's a special system providing the counteraction between the memory system and the coordinate system.
Взаимодействие между системой координат и памятью, обеспечивающей взаимодействие между системой координат и памятью человека называется сознание.
Of a human. And all together, how those two things act between themselves. All this setting and this system is called consciousness. Вот. This is what it means.
Вот.
So I guess in sketch it's much more clear and visible because this is how this system works against and with towards the coordinate system. How this one comes out of that one. How they work all together. And this is the consciousness.
То есть, когда вы без сознания, то есть память расцеплена с системой координат. Когда вы в сознании, память соединена с системой координат.
So, what we mean by saying someone's acting unconsciously, or subconsciously, right? By that state of things, we mean such case that stands for the fact when the coordinate system is being switched off the memory system. They are existing separately. You see, there is nothing as they connect, they're not connected to one another. And when the person lives in some kind of coordinate system and he doesn't turn to his memory system in such a way, he acts unconsciously. But by the consciousness and conscious action, we mean such action which are reproduced by the counteraction between the coordinate system and memory system when they stuck all together and when they work successfully. In such a way, we could claim that person works consciously.
То есть, как определить, человек в сознании или без сознания?
So, how are we capable of making a conclusion whether the person acts consciously or he acts unconsciously? What should we do for that?
Давайте посмотрим на пример.
Let's take an example.
Вот когда человек получил удар, и он находится в нокауте.
For example, when a person has just received such a strike that actually he was just knocked out of his feet and he's lying on the ground.
Да, как он приходит в себя? Какие стадии он проходит, когда он приходит в себя?
Being knocked down, he is actually unconscious, you know. So, but he's trying to retrieve his consciousness, and the retrieval of this consciousness could be followed and split into several stadia or into several levels. Let's pursue those levels. So, the first level is...
Сначала существует некая предстадия, то есть я осознаю, что я могу, вот стадия до открытия глаз, то есть биологически я жив.
So, the first level...
Она автоматическая стадия включения перед открытием глаз.
The first level is called an automatic level or automatic stadia when you're just being knocked off, you're still lying, your eyes are closed, shut down, and it's like some kind of biological switch which makes you think that, oh, I'm still alive and that's okay. So this is the first biological level.
Дальше открываются глаза.
After that, your eyes get open. You open your eyes.
Дальше вы пытаетесь шевелить руками, ногами. Все цело.
After that, you are trying just to use some parts of your body in order to know whether they are safe or no, whether you can use them or something is broken.
Дальше включается геометрия, то есть вы начинаете ориентироваться в пространстве, да?
After that, as the next step, the geometry around you is
again
just appears, like you're switching on the focus and you can just pay attention to what's surrounding you, where you are, what's as a scope, what's the area around you.
и это еще не в сознании человека.
But still, even when you're trying to switch some kind of focus, when you're working with some parts of your body, still you're not in conscious.
Вот вы собрались встать, вы собрались встать. Вот момент, когда вы готовы действовать, это момент прихода в сознание. То есть память замыкается с системой координат. Так вот, характерным признаком нахождения человека в состоянии сознания, это готовность действовать. Готовность действовать.
So the very next step, and it's utmostly important, is that when you try, when you already opened your eyes, when you already observed what's going on around you, and when you're ready to start acting, you want to get on your knees or just get straight. On that very moment, when you're ready to act, we should claim that the person has already overcome his consciousness. He retrieved his consciousness and he is unconscious. So this is that very moment when his memory system gets stuck with the coordinate system, and the person, as a matter of fact, and as a result of this collaboration, is ready to work.
Понятно, да? Mm-hmm. Да. И правильно судья на ринге говорит: посмотри мне в глаза.
So as for the boxing rank, you know, there are special referees who just come to the boxer, and after those boxers were knocked down, they received such a question from the referee.
Да, он говорит, смотри мне в глаза.
Referee asks,
глаза мне смотри, подними руки, он ему говорит. Подними руки.
And he's asking the boxer, look into my eyes. Just put your hands up. Look into my eyes once again.
Ты готов дальше сражаться?
And the referee asks, are you ready to continue the fight? Are you ready to act?
И когда он ему осмысленно, глядя в глаза, говорит, да, я готов дальше сражаться, готов дальше, я готов действовать. Он пришел в сознание, значит, можно продолжать поединок.
And only after the boxer, consciously looking straight forward into the eyes of the referee, is claiming he is ready to act, only by this moment it is completely clear that the boxer is unconscious, and he is actually ready to act, and he is ready to pursue and continue his fighting.
Понятно, да? Так действует механизм номер три. Но мы механизм номер три будем изучать, углублять в процессе его изучения в академии на протяжении всего периода обучения.
So this is an example demonstrating how the third mind system works. Just to know, to make you get sure of the principles, right? But this is for now, this is the end of the explanation of how the third mind system works, because we are going to deepen our knowledge, we are going to continue our research of that item following the process of our studies on the academy. So we are going to learn more about it, but a little bit later.
Сейчас мы сделаем перерыв 15 минут.
So we are going to take a break for 15 minutes, right?
Да, и я вас продолжу над вами издеваться. Я буду дальше над вами издеваться сегодня, как бы, потому что нам нужно, так сказать, еще некоторые вещи обсудить сегодня.
And after the 15-minute break, we are going to continue our collaboration. Even though your mind and your brains are boiling, still there are certain things that should be understood and learned about. So that's it.